The Coast Guard is searching for a missing fisherman.
In a strange twist, it turns out to be the same man who was lost at sea just a matter of months ago. You may recall back in December, Ron Ingraham was found alive after drifting in the open ocean for 12 days. He'd survived on raw fish and 1 gallon of water.
And then early this morning, a 34-foot fishing boat hit the reef off Lanai. Ingraham was on that boat along with a friend. The Coast Guard rescued the other man.
But the search continues tonight for Ingraham. Bridget Namata spoke to the friend who says obviously he's worried about his friend Ingraham. Bridget.
Yeah, that's right, Howard and Marissa. Kenneth Quarter is a commercial fisherman and says he and Ingraham have done that run hundreds of times. Quarter says they had just finished fishing and were heading home to Molokai with their catch. But first, they took a quick break to eat and relax. That's when a huge wave picked the vessel up, lifted it onto the reef, and within 15 seconds, the boat was in pieces.
You can hear the terror in Quarter's voice in his mayday call. After the fishing vessel was destroyed, Quarter says he and Ingraham jumped into the water.
And I said, come on, let's get out of here. He grabbed a big piece of wood, I grabbed a big piece of wood, and we had the orange life ring, and I could see the E-perp out in the deeper water, and I told him, Ron, hold on to the piece of wood and the life ring. I'm going to take my wood. I'm going to go grab the E-perp. I'll be right back. When I came back, the orange life ring was gone. The piece of wood was gone. Ron was gone.
Quarter says he spent hours yelling to Ingraham, hoping to hear his friend's voice. But all he could hear was the sound of waves while he clung to a piece of wood and the E-perp, an emergency position indicating radio beacon that the Coast Guard says saved his life.
Roughly 4 minutes before our bingo, which is the time that we're fuel limited, located a small light in the water. We diverted our aircraft from the search at that point. And acquired one person in the water.
And waited for 3 hours, watched the Coast Guard go up and down Lanai looking for me, in and out. And they kept missing me by about 30, 40 feet. Finally, one time they saw me, pulled me out of the water and dropped me off in Maui.
Quarter says the ordeal left him with a few minor scrapes, but he feels sick at the thought of Ingraham still out at sea.
Totally numb right now. I'm mind boggled.
The search continues for Ingraham.
The Coast Guard has going out every 8 hours, the search is nonstop until they find the missing mariner.
Meanwhile, Quarter is trying to contact Ingraham's family, but he lost his phone while out at sea. He says the experience has scarred him forever.
It probably will be my last fishing trip after what I went through. I'll probably never go fishing again.
The Coast Guard says Hawaiian waters are more survivable than other waters and has an MH-65 helicopter as well as boats and rescue swimmers out searching for Ron Ingraham. Bridget Namata, KHON2 News.